Posthumous Man is about a man named Elliot Stilling who wakes up in a hospital after a suicide attempt and sort of becomes infatuated with his nurse, who's a sort of shady character, and she gets him involved with some even shadier characters. And as the novel progresses, we find out why Elliot tried to kill himself. In some ways, that's the main mystery of the novel, sort of why, what in his life led him to this moment. I had heard about people who had died for a few minutes. One of the things that happens in the book is that he dies for 3 minutes on the in the emergency room and then comes back. So in a way, it's a sort of rebirth. And the idea of that, because I'd read about people who had gone through this experience of dying for just a minute or two, and then what happens to them after that, was very, very interesting to me. And I thought that to have it placed in the context of someone who had tried to kill themselves, and then to be sort of granted this second life, was really interesting thing to explore. The crime novel's always dealt with transgression. It's always dealt with people who have done bad things. And if you look at things like the detective novel, that's about a detective going and uncovering this evil that has been done. Which, I like those books, but those aren't really the books that I write. I write noir. I write books about people who actually commit the crimes. Because what's interesting to me is what happens to people who have transgressed. And so something like The Posthumous Man, the main character is someone who has done this terrible thing to himself. And you mentioned the religious connotation. One thing you find out, I guess it's in chapter two, so it's, I'm not giving too much away, but you find out very soon that he was a pastor, that he was a minister, a Christian minister, and that he had, so that makes it even more complicated that he would commit suicide. And you're thinking, well, why would this man who's seemingly supposed to have all the answers do this terrible thing? And so the rebirth part of that makes it even stronger, I think, because not only is he a minister, but he's a minister in fundamentalist Arkansas, which is where I'm from. And so the idea of being born again, being a born again Christian, is this very strong thing. So it's really the bedrock of the religion, this idea of being born again. Well, the books come out of my religious background, but they also come out of the sort of this place that I'm from. I'm from this rural place in Arkansas, which is a small state, a pretty small state in America. And it's a place that doesn't get written about very often. And so I moved away from there years ago now. I live in Chicago now. But I really can't write about anywhere else. I keep returning to Arkansas. It's sort of, in some ways, along with religion, Arkansas is my main theme. Those people from that place and what it's like for them and what it's like to be in their lives. It's a place with a lot of, I mean, it's a great place. It's a beautiful place with a lot of wonderful people. But it's also a place that has a lot of poverty. It's a place that has a lot of the drug problems that you find in rural America. So just exploring those kind of things was very interesting to me and a main part of what I do, I think.